Hi all, Andy from Solar Reviews again, and today I wanted to make a video about answering the question of how much output or how much electricity or power do solar panels produce on a rainy or a cloudy day. It's an age-old thing with solar panels that people, you know, buy. Let's say you buy a 6 kilowatt solar system and you turn it on in the middle of a sunny day, it's not going to be producing 6 kilowatts of power. What that means is that system is capable of producing 6 kilowatts of power at standard test conditions. So standard test conditions are 1 kilowatt, which I think is 3.6 megajoules per square meter, but 1 kilowatt of a radiation shining on the panel at 25 degrees Celsius cell temperature. And keep in mind the cell temperature inside a cell is typically hotter than the ambient temperature. But anyway, they're standard test conditions. And so when a system is rated and a panel is rated, they shine that much irradiation on a panel with the cell temperature at that temperature, and they measure how much it produces. So, you know, let's say you have a 300 watt panel, although more typically they're around 400 now, and you have 20 of those and you've got a 6 kilowatt array. You get that installed, you're turned on, it's the middle of a sunny day in spring or summer, and you think, well, great, I'm going to get 6 kilowatts of power. Well, no, you're not. There are inherent losses in solar systems from, you know, cabling, inverter conversion, panel mismatch, things like that. Basically, what you're going to do, even in really, really good conditions, you're probably only going to get about an 80%. So this is the middle of the day, full sun. You're generally only going to get around 75 to 80% of production. And so if you get a 6 kilowatt system installed, don't ring up and think you've been robbed because, you know, in the middle of a sunny day, it's producing 4,500 watts. That's probably about right. You know, I tend to say really good conditions, about 75% of your rated capacity, you know, sort of between 10 and 2 in the day, 10 and 3 maybe. You know, you should be able to getting that sort of rating. Depending on temperature though, as temperature goes up, you know, the output will fall. And that's one of the reasons that typically in full sun, the internal cell temperature inside a panel is going to be warmer than 25 degrees Celsius. 25 degrees Celsius is about 80 degrees Fahrenheit, give or take a little bit. So the question then is, all right, we got a 6 kilowatt array in really good conditions in the middle of the day, full sun, you know, when it's not too hot, it's probably gonna produce 75 to 80%. So it might produce between say 4,500 and 5,000 watts for your 6 kilowatt array, something like that. How much is it gonna produce in rain and cloud and snow? So the reason I guess we chose to sort of make this video today is it happens to be a cloudy day and with a bit of intermittent cloud. And so what we have here is we have a couple of arrays, one to my left and one to my right, that are about 18 kilowatts, so the ground mount arrays. I have some Fronius Simo string connect inverters down in my battery bunker. And so what we've been observing is these things have been running at about 9 kilowatts, but when the cloud comes over, it's not heavy, thick cloud, so it's not, you know, heavy, heavy rain. It's sort of white cloud rather than dark gray or black cloud. You know, that's going down to about 6,000 watts. So we're getting down to these 18, rather than these 18 kilowatt arrays when the sun comes out right now producing, it's about 2 o'clock in the afternoon, I think, producing about 50% of their nameplate capacity, I guess. Then they're coming down and then they're producing about, well, I guess 6 out of 18, so about 33% of their nameplate capacity. And when you get rain, usually that, you know, is accompanied by heavier, thicker clouds, and the thicker the cloud layer and the darker the cloud layer, the more that the output will fall. And so it's not uncommon to see panels, you know, producing down as low as 10 to 20% of their rated nameplate capacity. So probably the lowest I've ever seen one of these 18 kilowatt arrays at, you know, during the day when it's actually on, is probably about 2000 watts, which is, I guess, only about 10 to 15% of its rated nameplate, you know, capacity of the system. So heavy snow, to a certain amount of snow, they'll still work. After a certain amount of snow, they'll stop working. But I guess the bigger point to make about this you know, how much does this matter? Does this mean, you know, what you sometimes hear is people say, oh, well, you know, solar's not economic for me because I get snow or we get a lot of cloud. I guess there's about 350 different weather stations that are used to mark distinct climatic zones. And so really there is one for every area where the climate is certainly is different. And so although you do get years where there's more and less irradiation, like in Australia right now, we're going through a year where there's been less irradiation than there typically is. And we actually have had clients, I own an installation company here in Australia as well. And we have actually had clients ring up and say, hey, I've got this power bill. And really it's because it's rained, you know, right through spring, which is very, very unusual in Australia. It's normally a very dry place. So you do get years where there is some variance, but what we do know from measuring those weather stations, you know, the science as to what your array will produce over a year is very well known. So you don't need to worry that, oh, well, I'm not gonna get as much power. You will get as much power as your solar company tells you will, because whether they use, you know, most of the solar companies use professional solar estimating software, and almost all of that professional solar estimating software is built on data that originally came out of the NREL, the National Renewable Energy Laboratories, and they've basically done the science on how much solar irradiation, firstly, you get at each location around America in almost every zip code, and how much solar output you get over the course of the year. So when your installer sizes a system, particularly in environments, you know, in many states, most states, you know, that have something close to one-to-one net metering still, when your installer sizes the system, they know how much you'll generate over the year. And so don't worry that, you know, there are cloudy days and there are areas where there'll be, you know, weeks and months where there is heavy snow and there'll be very little solar output. That can all be taken into account in sizing your system. And, you know, really all you need to check is annually your output is what they said it would be, because that's a way of knowing that all of your solar panels and your system's working correctly. For those of you who, you know, are concerned about how, you know, much solar your array might produce, and therefore whether it's going to be economic or viable for you to have solar because of snow or cloud issues, we've built an online open calculator that uses the weather data from NREL to basically forecast how much solar energy you'll get, and, you know, from your array over the course of a year based on your climate, which takes into account the amount of cloudy days you get, the amount of snow you get typically over the course of a year. As I said, there can be slight variances year to year, but typically this stuff has been proven over the last 10 or 15 years to be super accurate. Almost every system that I've sold, you know, when I've talked to the customer, you know, it's been within 1 or 2% of the output we told them they would get from the solar system. So it really has been, you know, very good. But we've built an open calculator. There's a link to it in the description below. But it's just solarreviews.com/solar-calculator. And in that, all you have to do is put in your zip code, and it basically pulls in your utility rates from your area, but it also pulls in the weather data from your area. And so it then tells you how much solar, you know, that your system will produce over the course of the year, given your climatic and conditions and your cloud and your snow loads and things like that, and rain and things like that. It will also show you the over the course of an average summer and an average winter day, you know, how much the panels will produce over the course of those average days. And then also there's a graph that over the seasons of the year will show you. And you can trust that that's really, really accurate, because over the years, you know, many, many customers, you know, have said, you know, come back, you know, a few years after getting a solar system from our installation company in Australia. And really, when we've looked at the numbers, it's really been typically, as I said, within, you know, 1 or 2%. So, you know, really very close. And all of the solar companies on Solar Reviews pretty much, I think, use professional estimating software, which uses that same meteorological data in working out their estimates. So I think you'll find it's pretty accurate, and it wouldn't be something I would be concerned about. But if you do want to check what a quote you get from a specific installer, if you're not sure they're telling you the truth, you know, jump on that open calculator. You can go through all that and find out all that information before you register. If you do want to get quotes from other local solar companies, then by all means, that's one of the great things that Solar Reviews does. It allows you to get to see the reputations of each of your local solar companies, and then, you know, choose, you know, which ones you want to talk to. And you can get between one and four quotes if you like. If you choose to register at the end of the calculator process, after you've seen all the results, you know, you can, you know, get those quotes. That's all for now. You know, have a good day, and we'll see you again soon.
If you enjoyed that, be sure to subscribe and watch some of our other videos.